Hi, my name's Ilma and welcome to my channel. I've been posting Christian blogs 12 straight years every day. Today I'd like to share Exodus 16 verses 22 to 30. Here's the Word of God. On the sixth day they gathered twice as much bread, two omers each. And when all the leaders of the congregation came and told Moses, he said to them, "This is what the Lord has commanded. Tomorrow is a day of solemn rest, a holy Sabbath to the Lord. Bake what you will bake and boil what you will boil, and all that is left over lay aside to be kept till the morning." So they laid it aside till the morning, as Moses commanded them, and it did not stink, and there were no worms in it. Moses said, "Eat it today, for today it is a Sabbath to the Lord. Today you will not find it in the field. 6 days you shall gather it, but on the seventh day, which is the Sabbath, there will be none." And the Lord said to Moses, "On the seventh day, some of the people went out to gather, but they found none." And the Lord said to Moses, "How long will you refuse to keep my commandments and my laws? See, the Lord has given you the Sabbath. Therefore, on the sixth day, he gives you bread for 2 days. Remain each of you in his place. Let no one go out of his place on the seventh day." So the people rested on the seventh day. Exodus 16, 22 to 30. Here's the poem I wrote inspired by those verses. On following the Sabbath. After the Israelites were provided with their bread and meat, Moses instructed the people not to gather manna on the seventh day. The Lord wanted them to set aside a seventh day to rest and honor him. But the Israelites were stubborn and some didn't stop gathering manna that day. Those who gathered on the seventh day didn't find any manna. Since they were given extra on the sixth day, they were to rest on the Sabbath. And here's my commentary. It amazes me how stubborn and disobedient God's people were at that time. We are no better because some of us also forget to follow and respect the Sabbath. It is a day for us to honor, thank, and praise the Lord. He rested from creation on the seventh day since we were made in his image. He wanted us to emulate what he did. Because of sin, it is hard for humans to give God the glory on our own. But if we walk in the Spirit and obey his commands, he will give us the ability to rest and set aside this one day of the week to praise the Lord who provides for all our needs. Reflection. Share some challenges you've had on respecting and honoring the Sabbath. And why do you think God requires this rest from work on this day? Well, in our modern day and age, unlike those the time of Moses, there were no electricity, there were no social media, there were no televisions, there were no distractions but work. So all they did was work and rest. But today, it is hard to do that because some of us have jobs that does not allow us to rest on a Sunday. And that's why when I became born again, I didn't want to work on Sunday. And it is very hard to request that when you are, like here, I'm now in Canada, and when they give you a day to work, you got to do it. Otherwise, you won't have the job. And so a lot of, especially Western countries, do not honor this tradition or this stipulation that God gave to his people. And in my case, I used to be in a different denomination where honoring the Sabbath is not really explained, because that denomination didn't really read the Bible. But now it is so clear in Exodus why God requires this commandment to honor the Sabbath. I think God requires this rest because he wants us to emulate that he rested on the seventh day when he did creation. He did 1 to 6 days of creation, and on the seventh day he rested. So in other words, he rested from working and creating. And I think he wants us to rest from working and creating. So in this case, they were not even allowed to gather the manna in the field because they were given as much on 2 days on the Saturday so that they will rest on that last day. I think God required this rest as a protection for us as well, because when we get so obsessed and workaholics, we forget God. And so he wants us to remember that that seventh day is for him, because he provided already work for us. He provided supply of our needs on those 6 days. So he wants us to give that last day for him, to honor him for all the things that he has done for us. So I think that's the reason why the Sabbath was created, for the Lord, so that he would be glorified for all the creation that he has done for us. Thanks for watching. I hope you check my website at ilmaars.com for artworks, photographs, and a copy of this blog. Please subscribe to my channel on YouTube so I could make more videos giving the Word of God. Have a blessed day. If you haven't already, check over 3,000 videos I've done on YouTube or Google. Just type Ilma's Palm Devotional. Have a wonderful day.